What is up, YouTube? Welcome to Panfro Games, and here we are once again with another tier list for Pokemon Unite. And I'm making this tier list because we just had some patch notes released for Pokemon Unite that definitely made some significant changes to the meta, in my opinion. And overall, some things have changed throughout the Season 2 early game meta, so I wanted to discuss that here today. But of course, next week we're going to have a major patch with Decidueye being added. But the things that changed was pretty much Greedent got nerfed pretty hard. Ninetales got a very interesting side buff, side nerf. Even though it was supposed to be a straight up buff, it didn't really work out at the end of the day for Ninetales. Gardevoir got a slight buff and a couple of bug fixes, but some held items were changed. So we're going to make this a really quick tier list video. Speaking of, Greedent, the nerf to one, it was a bug fix they fixed on the Unite move, and to Covet, which means he's just going to do you less damage. And then they nerfed Belch by a lot of percent, I believe by like a 50% ratio difference. And they did buff Bullet Seed, but Bullet Seed was overall still a bad move. He's honestly feeling like a low A character, high B at this point. I'm putting him in low A, because he's just very effectively annoying, and his early game is a little bit weaker because they nerfed Tackle, but overall, he's still a good Pokemon. He's just not going to two-shot you anymore. He may four-shot you now, but if you get four-shotted by Greedent, honestly, I'm going to put him in high B. I'm putting him in high B. He feels really good at scoring goals, but effectively as doing damage or really like knocking up the team, he's just not there. So I think that's the big change. I'm going to put Venusaur, honestly, I'm going to be real, guys. We're going to put him a high A. Venusaur's just still doing Venusaur things. I think that's a wonderful overall. Where's the low on Ninetales? Let's talk about Ninetales. I'm putting Ninetales in C. And the reason why I'm putting Ninetales in C is because they actually made Ninetales a little bit worse. And I had Ninetales in C last time, but the issue with Ninetales is they nerfed Ninetales' scaling until level 10. So essentially they made Ninetales the same character as Gardevoir, which is why we have Gardevoir in guard tier. The reason why Ninetales is not in guard tier is because Ninetales has a lot of stuns and the auto attacks are good, and Aurora Veil is like a good support move. But the issue is now Ninetales actually does less damage in the early and mid game. At level 10, Ninetales will start doing more damage than before. But the big thing with Ninetales is your early and mid game is actually where you're strongest. So it sort of ended up being a nerf to Ninetales, which is very unfortunate. And yeah, Gardevoir is still in guards here. This Pokemon has a lot of problems, and Psychic didn't. Psychic was not the reason why this Pokemon was not good. The issue with this Pokemon is it takes you need to be level 10 to turn on. Same thing with Garchomp. You need to be level 10 to actually be effective in a fight. If you're not level 10, you are a waste. You're a 4v5 situation. Both of these are not good junglers. Both of these Pokemon are very easy to gank in lane and take advantage of, and it's just at the end of the day, it's not a Pokemon. These are not Pokemon you want to really take. Which I'm also going to put Gengar in. Gengar literally cannot lane. He can only jungle. His jungle is not great. His ganks aren't that great, honestly, compared to the best junglers in the game right now. And he's just very squishy. Yeah, he has a high burst damage, but he's very squishy. He doesn't have the best escapes either overall. And I mean, there's just pretty much any Pokemon you would run in the jungle is gonna be better than Gengar at the end of the day. Who would run the jungle role? So Mr. Mime, very strong A tier. I'm loving this Pokemon. He's phenomenal. I definitely want to make more Mr. Mime content on the channel. He's just such a good Pokemon. He's if you are good with your barriers, he could be an S tier Pokemon, but overall I think he's A. He does tons of damage and he provides great support to the team. And same with Snorlax. I mean, Snorlax and Mr. Mime are like the support and defender version of each other, but they both have this big wall play, and if you're really good with using your walls, you can really do a lot of work. Absol, I'm actually gonna move up from C from my last tier list to B. Yeah, Absol, I mean, I'm feeling a little bit more friendly towards this Pokemon's gonna keep bouncing from B to C for me. Just because if you're really good with Absol, that early mid game can be absolutely devastating, and then you can just win the game from there. The issue is if you don't get fed, then you're just going to lose in late game, which unfortunately that's just what Absol does. Lucario is still a monster S tier, potentially best Pokemon in the game. Actually, I think the best Pokemon in the game is Cinderace. Still, Cinderace is just a nutty Pokemon. He just does so much damage. His DPS is crazy. He has a lot of crits. Because his DPS is so high, his crit item set is just super good on him. So, yeah, Cinderace is just a great carry Pokemon in the game right now. He's like one of the best laners, and he's like the best jungler too. Krustle, I'm going to put in C tier, but above low on Ninetales. Krustle, I feel like Krustle's just too gimmicky. He's all right overall. As a defender, he's just very weak. He's definitely the worst defender out of all of them. Greninja, I'm going to be putting Greninja in high B tier again. The issue with Greninja, he just ends up being worse Cinderace. He doesn't have as good DPS as Cinderace does, and he's more frail than Cinderace at the end of the day. And yeah, he's just honestly a worse Cinderace, but we'll see if that changes in the future. Townflame is definitely A tier. What Talonflame actually down here? I'm actually a little bit less hot on Talonflame now because Fly is really good, but outside of Fly, Talonflame's like just a dead Pokemon. But Zeraora is like the exact opposite of that, where Zeraora stays in the fight. He can survive. His DPS is just so crazy. He has the nice AoE of Discharge around him. His ultimate's great. He's just going to stay in S as the best jungler, in my opinion, overall right now. Charizard ends up being another B tier Pokemon. We haven't looked at Charizard in a while, but his ultimate is still great. Overall, he sort of does have a weaker early and mid game, but once he hits Charizard, it's pretty good, but it's not devastatingly weak like Garchomp. It's solid overall. He shouldn't jungle, though. I know people run him in jungle, but he really shouldn't jungle. Eldegoss, definitely best support. I'm liking Eldegoss as the second best Pokemon in the game. It's just this Pokemon's shields become heals, and it's crazy. You get a shield, and if you don't use the shield, it becomes a heal. And Leaf Tornado is crazy as well. The ultimate's fantastic and game winning. Cramorant is really like low B tier. This Pokemon is just, it's almost C tier at this point. Cramorant needs to be relooked at again. I think overall this Pokemon's just a bit disappointing in its current state. It just doesn't do anything special. It's just definitely one of the weaker attackers in the game. Its ultimate's the reason why you would pick it, and like it's strong early game, but after that, it's just, you're so much better off picking up either Cinderace, Venusaur, or Greninja. And then we got Blastoise here, who I'm actually not as hot on Blastoise as I used to be, so this may be surprising for some people. But I think the Rapid Spin moveset just doesn't exist. And then your damage is relatively gone. So you're running Hydro Pump Surf. Hydro Pump still like does decent damage to like frail Pokemon. But overall, your damage is not there anymore. Your Surf's good, but I'd rather have Slowbro Surf at the end of the day. And just Slowbro's kit overall at the end of the day. I think it just ends up being a better Pokemon. And then we got Pikachu. This is a lot of B tier Pokemon, which is a good spot. Also to mention, B is a good tier to be in. Pikachu is just a good attack support at this point. It's just honestly a better Alolan Ninetales, honestly. And the ultimate is pretty consistent now. And the moveset buff in the last patch, two patches ago now, has really helped them out. Wigglytuff is another B tier Pokemon to me. I think Wigglytuff is going to go up to high A now. I mean, low A. It shouldn't be even B. I just think Wigglytuff I know it's a support, even the defender color. It's a good Pokemon. That ultimate, I can't ignore it. I've won games because of that ultimate. That ultimate has saved my life too many times. And I think just alone, based on that ultimate, it's still good. I do wish Wigglytuff did a little bit more damage, but Cute Charm is still a crazy ability to have, and Sleep is game winning at times you play it right. And we're gonna have Slowbro, who I'm actually gonna put in low A as well. I put Slowbro here. The reason why I have Slowbro here is because Telekinesis Surf is such a great combo. You're playing with teams. However, if you're doing solo, Amnesia is fantastic as well. The only issue with Slowbro is you do need another Pokemon. He ends up being a support defender. So you do want another Pokemon with you to really capitalize on the things you're doing. But at the end of the day, your Surf is some of the best knockup in the game. Your ultimate ability is the best single target move. And that Pokemon will never escape that single target move unless Slowbro dies or unless they die. So I just really love Slowbro. I may be a little bit biased, but I think he's an A tier Pokemon straight up. Machamp is a low, he's like mid C. Honestly, Machamp, I think he needs a buff. He's been looking for a buff. It's been a long time since he had any patch notes on him. He definitely needs a buff of some sort. He's just in a really awkward place against all the other all-arounders, even when compared to Garchomp. Like, at least Machamp, at least Machoke does stuff, so that's why I have him over Garchomp. Blissey is like B tier. I would put Blissey like, I would put Blissey probably right here, honestly. Blissey's just a worse Eldegoss, but it's still a good Pokemon, and, you know, a good Blissey player is very nice, especially the early game is with this strong attack is pretty nice overall. Then we got Mamow, and Mamow is, I'm going to be running Mamow. I think Mamow is high B. I mean, B tier is massive, honestly. Yeah, I think Mamow's mine's B tier. I mean, this is a good Pokemon overall, good early game, but it is, you got to get to level 10. I think it's very hard when you're playing as Piloswine, but Swinub is so excellent. The Piloswine is very iffy and your ultimate is a bit iffy, but you're the best gold defender in the game, and that is something to write home about for sure. And last but certainly not least is Sylveon, and I'm going to put Sylveon in B tier as well. I just think Sylveon's damage reduction was just, I think it needs a little bit of a buff to put him back in A. I think Hyper Voice is just, I used to run it a lot, but now I just don't run Sylveon anymore. It just doesn't feel worth it. And this feels good if you're ahead already, but if you're at the same level as the opponent's Pokemon in the mid or late game, Sylveon just doesn't feel great. Well, guys, that's my tier list for this patch. Let me know below if you agree with my tier list or not, and we'll be back next week with another tier list for Decidueye, so I'm very excited. I'm hoping we get some big changes in that patch. Well, guys, have a great one, and subscribe if you're new, and I'll catch you guys next time. Peace out, and have a good one.